Another set of questions can be when you have been given three functions and the three functions are multiplied. In that case, you will have to apply again the product rule, because in multiplication always the product rule will be applicable. And in that case, d upon dx of y will be equal to vw derivative of u plus, then again it will be uw derivative of v, and then finally the last will be uv and derivative of w. So once you have to take derivative of u, once of v, and last of w. So like this it will be calculated. Let us see practical examples related to this. Now this is a practical question in which we have been given three functions u, v, w. So, and this is equal to y. So if we have to calculate its derivative, so we will apply the formula, that is, this is u, v and w. So first is vw, and derivative of u, that is x plus 1 plus, now its derivative will be taken, so x plus 1, x plus 3, and derivative of x plus 2 plus last will be x plus 1, x plus 2, and derivative of x plus 3. So just you have to take the derivative wherever we have written the sign of derivative, x plus 2 and x plus 3. Now derivative of this can be taken individually, derivative of x and derivative of 1. Derivative of x will be equal to 1, because 1 will come forward, 1 minus 1, 0, anything having power 0 is equals to 1 plus 0. So I am writing only 1 over here, plus here also x plus 1, x plus 3, and again we will take separate derivative, it will come out to be 1 for the last, x plus 1, x plus 2, and the derivative will again come out to be 1. So if you want to solve further, again you can open the brackets. So it will be x square plus 3x plus 2x plus 6 plus x square plus 3x plus x plus 3 and plus x square plus 2x plus x plus 2. So now we can add the squares, x square, x square, x square. So last line answer will be 3x square plus, now we can add x, 3 plus 2, 5. 8, 9, 11 and 12. So it will be 12x, then 6 plus 3, 9 plus 2, 11. So this will be the final answer. So this is how the three functions will be dealt. This is another question in which this also you can see there are three functions. Three things have been multiplied. So it will be u, v and w. So now again we take the derivative of this. So first will be ex into log x, and derivative of the first element, that is u x, plus x into log x and derivative of ex. And the third will be x and ex and derivative of log x. So one by one, three derivative will be taken. So here we get ex log x, derivative of x is equals to 1, so we need not write over here, plus x into log x, derivative of ex is always equal to ex, and last x into ex, derivative of log x is 1 upon x. So here we can say this will be deleted, here only ex will be left. If we observe in all the three, ex is common, so we can take ex common. So it will be log x left here plus x log x and plus 1. So this will be the final answer. Again, this is a question of derivative. So if you look at the function, this is one function and this is second function. So here again we can apply the product rule. So taking the derivative, we know that when we have two factors and we have to take the derivative, so how it is taken, if this is u, then derivative of v plus v and derivative of u. So solving this further, this will be like this, and we know that the derivative of e raised to power x is e raised to power x only, plus e raised to power x. Now this is log x half. This we can write, if I want to solve this further, so you can take it like instead of under root, we can write here half. This we have already discussed, so under root can be written as half. So here, if we have to take that derivative, now log x half. So we are taking the derivative of log x is half, 1 upon x. And so here we will take, so derivative of log x you all have seen is 1 upon x. So here it is log x half. So it will be this and d upon dx of x raised to power half. So this portion derivative that we have taken, it was the derivative of this part. Again we have to take the derivative of the internal part. So what we have to write here is 1 upon x power half into d upon dx of x power half. So this is what we have to write. So solving this further, so is equals to log under root x into ex plus ex. So if we want to write it again further below, it can be written as this, and x power half, so its derivative will be half x power minus half. So if we have to write x power minus half, we can write it below as well. Now let us see how further we can move ahead with this question. On both the sides we can see that e raised to power x is common, but before taking that, let us solve this portion further if we can. So it is log x into e power x plus e power x. So here this is 1 upon under root x. If we want to solve this, 1 upon under root x into 1 upon 2 x power minus half. So if we take this, this is 1 upon x power half, and we can write it like x power minus half also. So taking this 1 upon x, if bases are same, powers can be added. So minus half, minus half. So it will be minus 2 by 2. That is minus 1, right? So it will be 1 upon 2 x power minus 1. Or we can take this below as well, 1 upon 2 x below. So here, if you solve this, this comes out to be 1 upon 2 x. Now moving towards the last step, is equals to, if I take e raised to power x common here, so I will be left with log root x. And on the right hand side, it will be 1 upon 2x.